Hello, Gundam fans, this is Prop 92, and today I'll be looking at the 1144 High Grade VAF from Gundam the Origin. And I'm probably saying it wrong, could be WAF, could be VAF, could be VAFE. I think VAF sounds pretty good. Feel free to correct me in the comments, that's fine. But it's a very cool looking mobile suit, nonetheless. Very kind of bare bones. Definitely looks like more of a prototype looking mech. Like, compared to, like, what we get with the Zaku 2, but better than the, obviously better than the Mobile Worker. It's just really cool. It's something you'd see in the real military if they ever had mobile suits. Got the plain color, very simplistic looking. Does have nice detail, kind of real grayish, in terms of all the panel lines and marking. Sticker-wise, you got the one mono eye, in which you have two different ones. You can use this one, which looks more like it's lit up. And then you have the plain solid pink. And all the other stickers are just marking stickers. I use this one for the bazooka. Now you don't have to use any. The mono eye really is the only thing needed. And yeah, pretty cool. I don't think anything is reused from other models. I don't think. I could be wrong. But I looked at the goop. Test type. Or is it prototype? Whatever. It doesn't look like it is using anything. And I don't think the Zaku is either. Possibly, probably the all the gray joints and everything. But that's probably it. And I love the fact that the hosing is in the stomach to the backpack, so it completely frees up the waist. A very good idea. And things are pretty solid on this thing. I'm very happy with it. It looks overall something you see in the military, and I think it's pretty cool. It's nothing fancy or spiffy. Just, you know, just something for military. It's done. Now it has a double ball joint in the neck. It also has a hinge as well, so it's pretty good in the head. You also have the little groove, it's a groove, but where the hell is it? It's stuck in there, it's a little peg, so you can rotate the model eye. It's a little hard to get to. I find the ball joint here is very, very secure. So if I get a hobby knife, I can show you how that works. Kind of. Ooh, VP scrap. There we go. There. Okay. Yeah. It's very tight in there. And then you had... It's hard to get that in there. That neck joint does kind of make you wanna bend. Just get in your hole. Get in your home. Don't bite me. There. Alright. The arms are ball jointed. They have the polycap hinge. The shoulder armor is interesting. It actually has a little flap here that's separate. Right here. So when you bend the arm up, it goes inside. So the arm can go that far out. And a rotate below the shoulder. Double jointed elbow, ball jointed wrist. You got the... It's a ball joint in the stomach, so you got, like, it goes forward, so you got a bit of a ab crunch. And the ball jointed waist, very free. You got hinge front skirts. And ball jointed side skirts, but they have some of the other ones have it from Origin, where you can actually I'll show it. See, there's a big track here, so you can actually move it back to kind of get out of the way of the leg. Now the leg, much like with like a 1100, there is a track in the waist, so you actually move the legs forward together to get them farther for a kick. So they've been pretty far forward. And back some, and out, rotate at the hip, double jointed knee. You have a hinge in the ankle, which also can move side to side a little bit. You got a ball jointed foot, a little bit of flip-flop action, and when you do that, it also bends the foot and the heels. The same kind of thing some of the other ones from Origin have, where you bend it, the foot and the heel bends too. So articulation is really good, considering they helped with the hosing to help the stomach. And the skirts kind of get out of the way for the legs, and the extra joint in the waist. Yeah, it's a very articulate model. You wouldn't think it would be, but it's pretty good. I like it. Now this model has the Heat Hawk, just like the Zaku 2. And this is a store one. You can peg onto the side skirt if you want. Like that. And it also has the bigger one, which will hold in the hand. It's just, gotta get the sweet spot in the middle, so it doesn't, like, fall all the way to the blade. And you also have an open left hand, if you want to use it. And these ball joints, it's not the ball joint so much, it's this, oopsie, well there goes a hand. It's this cover here. It, makes the connection very tight, which is good. You definitely don't have any loose hands, but, yeah, just so you know, you gotta really yank on it to switch. And then you also have the trigger finger hand to hold the bazooka, which have the sticker there for the scope, which can move. The handle can move. And that is about it. It does seem to have a actual panel line all the way through here. So you don't have to be like, oh crap, C-line. No, it's supposed to be there. That's good. I do wish there was like a machine gun or something, because you only seem to have the bazooka. Which is fine and all, but I think a machine gun or something would have been helpful. But that's fine. And you also have the shield, which connects just like with the goof. You got little pegs here, which connect to the elbow. Just peg it in. And it's a pretty solid connection once you get it on. Now you also have the handle, so you have a running track that's ball jointed on here, so you can bring the shield up or down, and you can have the Waff hold it, the Waff, whatever it is. Oops. And you can hold it in the hand, but it's pretty good at staying on the arm. Now the other thing is, you might have noticed, it has the same kind of clamp mechanism like the Goof has, the Mobile Worker has, that's it. So you can switch out the arm. And let's get the Goof here. And switch out the machine gun hand. So I'm glad, I was worried they weren't going to do any more with this gimmick. But I'm glad they are. A little bit more to do with it. So you can easily swap that on there. And now the Waff has a gun hand. So that's neat. I like it. I'm really glad they're actually continuing it. So it's just a couple models. That is a good thing. At least I think so. And that is pretty much it, but I almost forgot. You can mount the bazooka on the back skirt. Got a couple holes back here. And it comes with a little mounting bracket. And it's shown in his butthole. And you can mount the bazooka. So you can just clip it right. Probably better to do it back here. Like that. So you can have it stored. If you want to have him holding the heat hawk. Which, would that fit here? Oh, that's cool. Okay, so you can do that. That's actually pretty neat. I like it better than the side skirt, because it tends to hit some things. So I think that's cool. Okay. So, good amount of storage on this thing, too. Alright, so those are the accessories. Pretty good. Yeah, I would have liked the machine gun, like I said, but it's still a nice amount of weaponry. Well, let's start off by comparing this to the Astaroth, which I still have here. You see, it's a little shorter than, like, a standard mobile suit, or a standard Gundam. Standard Gundam, pretty much. And then the Goof. It's also a little shorter. And how about the Dom? I think it's the Dom test type or prototype. I can't remember the names. You can see it's also shorter here. This is actually a really nice little collection of different mobile suits from the Origin, because they're all very distinctive, but they do look like they have similar parts, but they're still different. So that is the high-grade Waff, or however you want to call it. I like it. It's simple, and it has a lot of interesting pieces on it that seem to be new. I'm pretty sure they're new. I like the shoulders. The head is simple, but cool. The way the hosing goes is good. And I thought the feet were reused, but I think they're new. And it doesn't have a whole bunch of weaponry, but it does have a place to store pretty much everything, and they all work the way they should. So I think it's a nice, solid, standard kind of mobile suit. And that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.